Wellwood back to the blue line. Edler onto the other side. Kevin Bieksa shoots. He scores. Christian Ehrhoff gets the Vancouver Canucks on the board with some traffic in front. It's 5-3. Ehrhoff scores the goal. It's 1-1.
Well, maybe that is the spark that this team needs badly. We've talked a lot about bad penalties you don't kill. This is one that the Canucks keep alive as Kessler gets it back to the point. Edler moves laterally, and watch the work in front by Bernier. Knocks the defenseman into positioning, and that takes away the vision of Jonathan Quick. Look at Quick looking around at the last second, and this is a rocket that Bernier jumps and allows it to go through his legs. Good view of it here. Quick back deep in his crease thanks to the presence of number 18.
There's a pass up the middle on a King's change. 2-on-1. Demetrius shoots. He scores. Pavel Dimitra has tied the game 2-2 as Los Angeles got caught on the long change.
And Jim, kill a penalty, score a goal. I mean, the biggest momentum swing so far in this series for the Vancouver Canucks. They killed it off. They continued to put pressure on, and this is just a bad turnover by Sean O'Donnell, and then he goes and makes a change. Not only did he turn it over, but he didn't allow his man to get back in time as Johnson tried to get back. Dimitra looked off the pass to Wellwood, and it's just a perfect shot by Pavel Dimitra off the post and in, 13 inches stick side.
Dustin Brown up the middle, a breakaway for Alex Frolov. Great save, Luongo.
You get chances offensively to try to create something, and you hope your goaltender can bail you out, and that's exactly what Luongo did. He didn't overreact. He stayed square to the shooter Frolov. He had some backside pressure by O'Brien.
Henrik to Daniel to Shane O'Brien back to Daniel Sedin. Slap pass. Samuelson scores. And once again, the Vancouver Canucks have tracked down the Kings and tied the game 3-3.
Well, Michael Samuelson was brought here to bring some experience, some playoff experience, much needed. This is the most he has ever scored in a playoff series, his fifth goal. This play is made possible by the speed of Ehrhoff through the middle, driving, creating some problems, good quick movement side to side, and watch the play by Samuelson. Stick on the ice, slap pass from the point from Sedin. And as Henrik battling in front, good job by Ehrhoff getting there as well. And this is a tough play for Jonathan Quick. But Jim, Michael Samuelson had five goals all of last year.
Canucks held the puck in. Henrik, Sedin, Salo scores! Sammy Salo on the power play from Henrik Sedin, and Vancouver has the lead. It's a power play goal, no less.
Well, there's the impact players making the difference. The draws have been so critical. You saw in the power play goal the last time, very similar. Halpern breaks his stick on that initial shot, and that opens up the middle of the ice. Halpern went to get a stick after his broke. Right there, you can see he loses one, decides to go to the middle, so there's no support in the middle of the ice. Hanzus can't get the shooting lane.
Simmons with a pass to Ryan Smith. What a great stick by Henrik Sedin. Out he starts, 4-on-2. Daniel Henrik scores! The scoring champ, Henrik Sedin, with under 3 minutes to go, did the work himself this time. And I can't remember ever seeing Henrik Sedin more excited.
Folks, you want a celebration, a little bit of emotion, nothing like the pressure of game four. This all happened in the defensive zone. A good battle down low. Henrik keeps the puck alive, up to Daniel. Watch this pass by Daniel, through traffic, and a good aggressive play. Look. Everybody in the building's thinking pass with Henrik Sedin. Hadn't scored in 9 games and comes up, stops up, and makes a perfect shot.
Alex Burrows along the boards against a pinching Jack Johnson, and he scooped the puck out to center. Down to 20 seconds to go. Here's Drew Doughty straight up the middle, intercepted. Kessler hits the open net, and Vancouver should be able to steer this home now. 6-4 with 17 seconds to go.
Oh, what a shock, Los Angeles Kings bench. And the Vancouver Canucks, for the 12th time this season, able to pull out a victory after being down going into the third. The momentum changes in this game are incredible. The energy level that the Kings had early on looked like they were going to dominate. Doughty trying to force one up the middle. Kessler sitting in the weeds, picking that one off. And this is a culmination of just a huge comeback and maybe series-saving effort by the Vancouver Canucks.
And what a third period for Daniel and Henrik Sedin with 5 points. Henrik missed the open net. Kessler bailed him out as Matt Green takes a shot wide of the net. Sean O'Donnell takes a desperation final shot. And there's still some more shots to be taken. Shane O'Brien went at Wayne Simmonds. Matt Green goes at Shane O'Brien. And there's some real emotion and anger here. O'Brien has Matt Green in a headlock now.
And importantly, Vancouver players have come out to celebrate, and they're all getting corralled back by Alain Vigneault.
That's Kevin Bieksa and Wayne Simmonds over with the boards.
Well, it's game on, series on.
Big time.
As you expect.
What a different game, though, because Vancouver looked so flat, nervous. Didn't have any energy, probably because of the nervousness early on, but boy, they threw caution to win in the third period, didn't they?
Very similar to game three, where I thought it was the opposite. The Canucks had all kinds of energy early, and the Kings a little nervous. Here's how it began. Simmonds and O'Brien, as we've seen in the boys showed in between periods, O'Brien's been at the center of it all night long. And then he and Green go after each other, and the scrum ensues. Everybody pairs off. And cooler heads prevail, but boy, none prevailing more than the Vancouver Canucks.
And so the scene shifts back to Vancouver. Friday night, 7 o'clock Pacific, game number 5. Series tied 2-2 after a big Vancouver comeback and a 6-4 win over the Kings in LA.
Let's start with the goal. Jim Houston said, as he called it, he had never ever seen you so excited after scoring a goal for.
I know. I was at the time, two and a half minutes left, or just the way we came back and everything. I was just happy to see Green. I mean, it's a great feeling. We needed that one for sure.
I think a lot of people in the Staples Center tonight, some of the Kings included, probably thought you were thinking pass. Were you thinking shoot all the way?
Yeah, when I got it from Danny, I thought I saw someone going to the far side there, but I thought I needed to shoot this one. If I would have passed it and they would have blocked or something, I would have been pretty mad at myself. So.
A lot of big plays, Henrik, in the third period. Aside from your goal, perhaps the biggest one was Luongo's breakaway save on Frolov. A game saver and perhaps a season saver?
Yep, for sure. We needed this game badly. I mean, we knew that coming in. It's tough to come back from a 3-1 deficit. And the way the guys battled tonight, and I thought our PK was better too. It's a huge step for us.
Yeah, on that topic, I don't think we'd ever thought we'd be making such a big deal over a couple of penalty kills. But with the way this series had gone for you guys, how can we not? Have you finally got that part of your game figured out?
I don't know. I think we worked harder today. We read off each other much better. They made some plays where we were able to get the puck from them, and we pressured them a little bit more, and it was tough to see their first two goals being on the power play. So we battled back and were able to kill a couple off.
Were you surprised, as everyone else, with the innumerable momentum changes in tonight's game?
That's the way it is. I mean, I don't know. It's this is playoffs. I mean, you look at every game, every series, that's a big goal, and all of a sudden the momentum has changed. So that's what playoff is all about.
I want to ask you about the itinerary. You guys have had the advice of a sleep expert all season long to monitor your sleep patterns, and apparently the plan is for you to stay over here in Los Angeles tonight and fly out at 11 o'clock tomorrow morning. Are you okay with that?
Well,
you have to be.
After win, it's fine. It's fun, fine for sure. If you would have lost, it would have been a little tougher.
All right. It'll be a short flight under the circumstances. A shorter flight, I guess we could say.
For sure.
All right. Thanks a lot.
Thank
Henry.
You.